The next topic is Coriolis force or Coriolis effect.
What is Coriolis's effect is?
Coriolis's effect generally means deflection, and this deflection happens because of the rotation of Earth.
When you take a physical concept, your wind system will move perpendicular to the isobars, whereas when it comes to geophysical concept, geophysical literally means that your Earth is making some kind of effect on the physical factors, and that effect is your rotation, and because of this rotation you end up with deflection on your wind systems, and this effect is a pseudo effect, which means it is a false force, and this creates Coriolis's effect. And according to Coriolis's effect, whatever object that is thrown in the northern hemisphere will get deflected to the right hand side, and whatever objects that are thrown in the southern hemisphere will get deflected to the left hand side. We'll get to an example. When you take the pressure belt systems of the world, in equator region you have a low pressure, and in subtropical region you end up with a high pressure. A wind system is being thrown from subtropical high pressure to a low pressure. If it is going to be a physical concept, your wind has to flow perpendicularly, but because of the rotation of the earth, your wind is getting deflected to the right hand side, which means that if I am standing at this point where the wind is being thrown, the right hand side is the wind's right hand side, where your wind will move towards the right hand side, and that is how you end up with northeast trade winds. In a similar way, if a wind system is going to blow from subtropical high pressure belt to subpolar low pressure belt, your wind will flow in perpendicular direction. It is a physical concept. As it is a geophysical concept, the right hand direction of the wind is this way, and that why you end up with another permanent wind system westerlies. Whereas with respect to the southern hemisphere, a wind system will blow from subtropical high pressure belt to equatorial low pressure belt. As I said, whatever is thrown in the southern hemisphere, it will get deflected to the left hand side. The winds will move to the left hand side of the wind system. You end up with the deflection, which gives rise to southeast trade winds. On the similar pattern, a wind is being thrown from subtropical high pressure belt to subpolar low pressure belt, which means a wind is being thrown from this region, but everything will get deflected to the left hand side, and you end up with westerlies again in the southern hemisphere. This is the effect your Coriolis's force will create. The Coriolis's force will also create an effect on cyclones. When you take cyclones, cyclones will always have a low pressure in the center and high pressure in the periphery, which means that wind always blows from high pressure region to a low pressure region. When you take cyclones in northern hemisphere, the winds will get deflected to the right hand side, and the right hand side of the wind system is this. It is this, and this way is the right hand side. This is the right hand side, which means that cyclones in northern hemisphere is rotating in anti-clockwise direction. Whereas when it comes to southern hemisphere with respect to cyclones, again you have low pressure in the center, high pressure in the periphery, and your winds will blow inward towards the low pressure, and winds will get
deflected to the right hand side. Winds will get deflected to the left hand side. So winds will get deflected in this pattern, which means that cyclones in southern hemisphere will rotate in clockwise direction, and this is going to be the vice versa for anticyclones, which means that anticyclones will have high pressure in the middle and low pressure in the periphery, and the winds will move outward from high pressure to a low pressure region. In northern hemisphere, your winds will get deflected to the right hand side. Your winds will get deflected to the right hand side, which means that anticyclones in northern hemisphere will rotate in clockwise direction, and in southern hemisphere it will rotate in anti-clockwise direction.